Hi guys, welcome to the class. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about jaw crushers and types of crushers we have, and that jaw crusher and bariatric crushers. What is a crusher? Crusher is nothing but reduction of materials which they are having, which the materials which passing from the crushers can be reduced. The size into 152 250 mm. So what is a crusher? Crusher is nothing but the size reduction equipment. A crusher is a machine designed to reduce large rocks into smaller or more manageable particles. Crusher is a machine which is used to crush heavy size particle into small size, and also it's a primary size reducer. Crushers are low speed machines which for core reduction of large particles can be used. Large particles can be used for to reduce their size. The approximate size of the reduced materials from the crusher ranges from 152 to 250 mm. So a crusher uses compressive force for breaking off particle. This machine, which the pressure is achieved by the two jaws, one jaw is kept stationary and is called a fixed jaw, while the other jaw, called a swing jaw, moves back and forth relative to it. Here in this diagram, you can observe here, this is the flywheel. This is the flywheel, balances inertia, promotes smooth operation, and these are the cheek plates. These are the cheek plates, which are made up of manganese steel castings, allow easy replacements if any breakage of these cheek plates can be happened. These are the jaw plates. These are the jaw plates which are fabricated, which are prepared, which are manufactured with a high manganese steel castings, can be reversed, allowing extended life. So these are frame plates. Here, these are the frames. Heavy duty design, steel plate welded construction, welded by carbon dioxide CO2 shield arc process, and stress relieved after fabrication. These are the toggle plates of cast iron, increase the safety factors, and these are the wedge or lug systems, allows easy replacement. This is the electric shaft, forged from hardened and tempered chrome molybdenum steel, particularly large diameters to suit heavy duty applications. In these types of crushers we have are jaw crushers and gyratory crushers. The difference between these two jaw crushers is the feed rate. The input of the materials rate has been varied between these jaw crushers and gyratory crushers. And product rate and design, however, going to talk about jaw crushers in this particular presentation. And here, jaw crusher is a type of crusher which produces coarse particles, The feed size of this jaw crusher is of 1500 mm to 40 mm, and the product size is from 50 mm to 5 mm in size. If we feed the jaw crusher for the coarse particles, the jaw crusher is inputted with a size of aggregates is a 40 mm, and the product which is reduced, the compression force which reduces the product which is inputted. So the output product size varies from 50 mm to 5 mm, 50 mm to 5 mm. So the compressive strength of jaw crushers is 320 megapascals. The RPM of these jaw crushers is between 200 to 400. These jaw crushers are heavy duty machines and hence need to be robustly constructed. So the outer frame is generally made of cast iron or steel. The jaws themselves are usually constructed from cast steel. They are fitted with replaceable liners, which are made of manganese steel. So this manganese steel helps in replacement, can be replaced easily. And these are fit. These jaws themselves are usually constructed from cast steel. This is the image of the jaw crusher. The working here, you can observe here the input. Here the input of the materials. The size of the aggregates can be put it here, the heavy size. And this jaw crusher reduce the size of these aggregates, which is put it into the jaw crusher, can be reduced by the compression and the actions done by the jaw crusher, and discharge can be collected here. The size of the aggregates can be varied. Here, the working principle of jaw crusher. A jaw crusher uses compressive force for breaking off the particles. A jaw crusher reduces large size rocks or ore by placing the rock into compression. A fixed jaw mounted in V alignment is the stationary breaking surfaces. So while the mobile jaw exerts force on the rock by forcing it against the stationary plate. If these the main working principle of these jaw crusher is the jaw crusher which uses compressive force for breaking off particles, and these jaw crusher reduces large size rocks or ore by placing the rock into compression. So a fixed jaw mounted in V alignment is the stationary breaking surface. So this mobile jaw exerts force on the rock by forcing it against the stationary plate. The space at the bottom of the V aligned jaw plates is the crusher product size gap, or the size of the crushed product from the jaw crusher. The rock remains in the jaws until it is small enough to pass through the gap at the bottom of the jaws. Here in this, the space between the space at the bottom of the V aligned jaw plates is the crusher product size gap, or the size of the crushed product from the jaw crusher. In the V alignment, the bottom V part can be fixed to which size the rock should be reduced. So that depends upon the aligned jaw plates, the crushed product size can be decided. So if the jaws in the V alignment has placed a very distance of 50 mm, so the aggregate which is discharged through the jaw crusher is the 50 mm size aggregates. If the jaw crusher V alignment has been reduced to 10 mm, so that the input amount of material, the raw aggregate, which is of 1500 or whatever the dimensions for the size of the particles. If it is reduced to 2, if the size of the aggregates is reduced to 2, 10 mm, then the product can be discharged. Then the reduced size of the aggregates can be discharged through the gap at the bottom of the jaws. Bottom of the jaws. Here you can observe if the V element which here provided is of a gap of 50 mm. Here the aggregate size which we allowed can be reduced by the compression force, by the jaw crusher, and the discharge of the size of the aggregate is of 10 mm or less. 10 mm or less. If the size of the aggregate is not of 10 mm until it gets reduced to 10 mm, the aggregate is crushed between these doors in these jaw plates, so that the out product which we receive is not greater than 10 mm. Not greater than 10 mm. Jaw crusher. The volume or cavity between the two jaws is called the crushing chamber. The volume or cavity, the space between these two jaws is called the crushing chamber. The movement of the swing jaw can be quite small. The movement of the swing jaw can be quite small. Since complete crushing is not performed in one stroke, the inertia required to crush the material is provided by the weight-end flywheel that moves a shaft, creating an electric motion that causes the closing of the gap. Here, the movement of the swing jaw can be quite small, so that the complete crushing is not performed in one stroke. So it takes some time for crushing of the aggregates to the size of the V element which we provided, so that it cannot complete the crushing in one stroke. So it takes time for completing of the crushing of aggregates into required dia, required size. So the inertia which required to crush the material is provided by a weighed flywheel that moves a shaft, creating an electric motion that causes the closing of the gap, so that the inertia required for the aggregate to be crushed in the jaw crusher, the inertia which required to crush that particular aggregates which were provided into the jaw crusher, can be that inertia can be provided by the weight end flywheel which moves shaft, creating an electric motion that causes the closing of the gap. The angle between two jaws is between of 20 to 30 degrees. So in the jaw crusher, we are having two plates. In the jaw crusher, we are having two plates opposite to each other, so that these angle between these two jaws is between 20 to 30 degrees, so that the inclined position of the one jaw plate can be seen, so that the aggregates can slip to the bottom of the jaw crusher and maintain the dimensions which we require to attain at the output. So the larger lumps caught between the upper part of the jaw and broken into small pieces by the impact force which is developed by the electric motion of the jaw crusher. So the small pieces come to narrower space at the bottom, where compression force do a sufficient size reduction and product obtained. Here, small pieces come to narrower space at the bottom, where compression force do a sufficient size reduction and product obtained at the output. So the types of jaw crushers we are having are classified into two types: Blake jaw crusher and Dodge jaw crusher. Both crushers employs a compressive force for size reduction. In this both Blake or Dodge jaw crusher, they both crushers employs a compressive force for size reduction. Brake jaw crusher. In the Blake jaw crusher, the swing jaw is pivoted at upper position. The greatest amount of motion is at the bottom, which means less choking can be observed in this Blake jaw crusher. So in the Blake jaw crusher, the swing of the jaw is pivoted at the upper position so that the greater amount of motion, the greater amount of reduction of the material can be observed at the bottom, which is less choking of aggregates in the top. Less choking of aggregates can be seen in the Blake jaw crusher. And in the coming to in that Dodge jaw crusher, in the Dodge jaw crusher, the swing jaw is pivoted at the bottom position. It has a greater tendency to choke. So if the swinging jaw, which is pivoted at the positions at the top or bottom, depends upon the swinging of the jaw, these pivoted at the upper position, this is known as Blake jaw crusher. And also if the pivoted swing jaw is attached at the bottom position, this is known as Dodge jaw crusher. In the Blake jaw crusher, the choking is not plays a major role, because at the top of the jaw crusher is pivoted so that the choking is lessly observed in this Blake jaw crusher, and it's quite opposite for the Dodge jaw crusher. So the Blake jaw type, the Blake type of jaw crusher has fixed feed area and a variable discharge area. So that in the Blake type, the fixed feed area, so that the fixed dia of the aggregates can be feeded, and also the fixed amount of feed can be given into this Blake type of jaw crusher. So a variable discharge between 50 mm to 5 mm of discharge area can be presented at the Blake type of jaw crusher. The great amount of motion is at the bottom of V, which means that it has a little tendency to choke. Here you can observe in this image, the pivoted area is being attached at the top of the top portion, so that the bottom portion can move freely and the aggregates which we feed at the top can travel easily. If the dia of the aggregates are small, they can directly travel to the bottom and they can be sorted to that particular dia which we provided, 50 mm or 55 mm to 50 mm dia of gap can be provided at the bottom of the V alignment and can be discharged through this unit. Single toggle jaw crusher. In the single toggle jaw crusher, the swing jaw is suspended on electric shaft, which leads to a much more compact design than that of double toggle jaw crusher. The swing jaw suspended on the electric undergoes two types of motion. Swing motion towards the fixed jaw due to the action of toggle plate, and vertical movement due to the rotation of the electric. So two types of movements can be seen in this single toggle jaw crusher, because it is suspended, the swinging jaw which is suspended on the electric shaft. So the swing motion towards the fixed jaw and a vertical movement due to rotation of the electric. These both motions when combined lead to an elliptical jaw motion. This motion is useful as it assists in pushing the particles through the crushing chamber. This phenomenon leads to higher capacity of the single toggle jaw crusher, but it also results in higher wear and tear losses of the crushing jaws. So this is highly impactful when compared to the Blake and Dodge jaw crushers,
but this leads, this impact leads to the higher wear and tear of the crushing jaws. These type of jaw crushers are preferred for the crushing of softer particles. If the hardened particles have been crushed in this type of single toggle jaw crusher, the wear and tear, so the jaws can be broken easily due to the two movements we have seen previously. Double toggle jaw crusher. In the double toggle jaw crushers, the oscillating motion of the swing jaw is caused by the vertical motion of the pitman. So the pitman moves up and down, the swing jaw closes. It moves towards the fixed jaw when the pitman moves upward and opens during the downward motion of the pitman. This type is commonly used in mines due to its availability to crush tough and abrasive materials. So in the Dodge type jaw crushers, the jaws are further apart at the top than at the bottom, which formed a tapered shoot so that the material is crushed progressively smaller and smaller as it travels downward until it is small enough to escape from the bottom opening. In this Dodge jaw crusher, the opening of the input area of the jaw crusher is high when compared to the top bottom part, which forms a tapered chute so that the material is crushed progressively smaller and smaller and smaller, even smaller as it reaches to the bottom of the crusher to escape. The greatest amount of motion is at the top of V, which leads to choking. In the Dodge jaw crusher, the pivoted joint is at the bottom so that the choking can be seen highly when compared to the top blank jaw crusher. The Dodge jaw crusher has a variable feed area and a fixed discharge area, which leads to the choking of the crusher. So in the Dodge jaw crusher, we have variable feed area. We have different amount of feed areas can be arranged. So the discharge area remains constant and fixed so that the choking of the crusher can be seen, which is used only for the laboratory purposes and not for heavy duty operations. These Dodge jaw crushers are only used in the laboratory purposes and for not any heavy duty operations. These are the type of Dodge jaw crushers. Here you can see the opening area is high when compared to the, this is a variable feed area where the input of the aggregates can be increased, and this is the fixed bottom area so that the discharge can be choked. The materials which we passed from the feed area to travel so far to escape that into the discharge area, the feed area must not be enlarged with respect to the top discharge area. So the choking can be observed with the different variable feed areas. The advantages of jaw crushers. Here, the simple construction makes for easy maintenance, which are stable performance and also gives high crushing ratio, low operational cost. Here, while operating these jaw crushers, the operational cost is less when compared to the ordinary crushing of aggregates can be seen. The high capacity of equipments can be used for the crushing of aggregates into smaller sizes. So adjustable discharge port can be seen industrial applications. There are different purpose of industrial applications can be seen. The crushers are majorly wide range of use of these crushers can be seen in the mining, cement industries, fertilizer industries, and animal feed plants, herbal plants, cement plants, and ceramic plants. So in these, the materials which has to be the ready mixed concrete batches also using these crushers, because the aggregates they have to use for the different various sizes, so the crushers can crush the aggregates in reduced sizes. Reduction of the aggregates can be seen by using these type of crushers. So in the heavy duty mining, the mining particles cannot be lifted as large as the mining particles has to be there, so they have to be crushed into parts to carry to the outwards. So these crushers are used in the mining, cement industries and fertilizer industries mostly. And also coconut shell plants, salt plants, mines and minerals, agro-based industries, others where size reduction required. So the others are the main aggregate reductions. These aggregates has a higher capability of breaking the jaw crushers, the jaws of the crushers, so that these particles can be repeatedly not used in the crushing of the aggregates. So long-term durations, long capabilities of crushing of aggregates by a single jaw crusher can't be seen. There has to be, the plates has to be changed for time to time so that the output can be seen appropriately in the jaw crushers in aggregates. Gyratory crushers. The gyratory crushers look like a jaw crusher with circular jaws between which material is being crushed some point all the time. So the rotation per minute of this gyratory crusher is of 125 to 425 gyrations per minute. So to give a continuous discharge, because some part of this crushing leads to head working at all the time. So it produces up to 4,500 tons per hour of material being crushed in the gyratory crushers. When compared to the jaw crusher, this is highly used, and the heavy duty mining areas can use these type of gyratory crushers to produce high amount of materials to be crushed. So a gyratory crusher is similar in basic concept to a jaw crusher, consisting of a concave surface and a conical head. Both surfaces are typically lined with manganese steel surfaces. The inner cone has a slight circular movement but does not rotate. The movement is generated by an eccentric arrangement. As with the jaw crusher, materials travel downward between the two surfaces being progressively crushed until it is small enough to fall out through the gap between the two surfaces. Here, the working principle for the jaw crusher and the gyratory crusher is similar, so that the particles which go downward smaller and smaller and even smaller until it escapes from the discharge point. Here you can observe this is the gyratory operators, where the input of the aggregates can be seen at the top, so that here at the top. So these are reduced as the aggregates are going downwards. These are reduced, the reduction of the aggregates getting smaller, smaller, smaller until it's reached the nominal size which we provided, so that the output can be seen and a large amount of aggregates can be reduced, approximately of about 4,500 tons per hour. Amount of aggregates can be crushed by using these type of gyratory crushers. Thank you, and
see you in the next class.